If I could have your attention for just a few announcements as we begin. That was very good, thank you. Impressive. Well, good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to Liberty High School's 43rd commencement exercises. We are gathered here this afternoon to honor the class of 2024. The senior class has asked us that you help in making this a dignified ceremony. Applause is the preferred expression of joy on this very happy occasion. Please remember that our seniors and their families have waited 13 long years to hear their names called as they walk across the stage. There is a professional photographer who will take a picture as each graduate processes across the stage. Photos of your graduate can be ordered online. Information for how to order those photographs is in the packet that your senior will bring home to you following the ceremony. Their diploma is also in that packet, so you might want to make sure that you get that. Please do not approach the stage during the ceremony, and please silence those wonderful cell phones at this time. We would prefer that phones not ring while we're honoring our graduates. For the hearing impaired persons in the audience, family members can direct their attention to my left where there are interpreters. When our graduates process in just a moment, we ask that you remain seated so that everyone can see our graduates process. And then when the final graduate has reached their seat, the class president has entered, then you may stand with a roar of applause to cheer for your graduates as they enter. In just a few moments, we will welcome the class of 2024. Thank you.
Thank you.
class of 2024.
Thank you. Thank you. Good afternoon. We ask that the graduates and audience please remain standing for the Pledge of Allegiance and the National Anthem. Following the Pledge of Allegiance, the Liberty High School Chorus will lead us in the National Anthem. Now, would the Liberty High School Chorus please come forward? Gentlemen, please remove your hats. Graduates and audience, please be seated. Good afternoon. I am Ken Goncz, principal of Liberty High School. Thank you all for joining us for this very special occasion. I would like to introduce the dignitaries seated on the stage with us. I ask that you stand as I announce your name and that the audience please hold their applause until all the guests have been introduced. Several special guests are here to share this momentous day. It is indeed a pleasure for us to have you here as we celebrate the Liberty High School commencement and the accomplishments of the class of 2024. Would you please stand and be recognized as I call your name? Dr. Cynthia McCabe, Superintendent of Schools. Mr. Eric King, Director of High Schools. Commissioner Mr. Ed Rothstein. Mr. Steve Whistler, Board of Education member. Ms. Tara Battaglia, Board of Education member. Ms. Meghan Brown, Assistant Principal. Mr. Chris Merson, Assistant Principal. Student Speaker, Flematu, Fofana. Valedictorian, Alexys, Esfandiari. Salutatorian, Cameron Fear. Class President, McKenna Wright. Board of Education Student Representative, Sahi Sudhakar. And Faculty Speaker, Mr. Harrington. The Class of 2024 Advisor, Mrs. Larson, please stand. Thank you for doing a tremendous job working with our seniors over 4 years. On stage, we have the Senior Advisors, Mrs. Azak, Mr. Bangle, Ms. Davis, Mr. Durkin, Ms. Grantland, Mrs. Grogan, Mrs. Hudson, Mrs. Kim, Mrs. Larson, Mrs. Latine Dallas, Ms. Nolan, Mr. Romero, and Mrs. Rowinski. Let's have a round of applause for our I would also like to welcome some guests that are seated either to my right or elsewhere in the gymnasium. Ms. Kathy Kaufman, Supervisor of Special Education. Mr. Greg Killian, Assistant Supervisor of Visual and Fine Arts. Mrs. Maria Martin, Supervisor of Student Support Services. Let's give them a round of applause. For any other guests from our central office who are here with us today, please stand. For any current or former county teachers, please stand. After 43 years, Liberty High School has a large alumni group. For any alumni of Liberty High School, please stand. I'd like to give a special thank you to Mrs. Hotchkiss and Ms. Brown, who were instrumental in the coordination of today's ceremony. Thank you very much. Another group of special adults here with us today are the faculty and staff of Liberty High School. The names of the faculty and staff are printed in your program. In addition to the faculty on stage, some faculty are in the VIP section to my right, while others are at other locations within the gymnasium. Our teachers are a talented and dedicated group who have worked diligently over the last 4 years to prepare the students in the graduating class to be college and career ready. Faculty and staff, please stand. I'd like to recognize our retirees, starting with Mrs. Michelle Freeman, who has been 17 years at Liberty as an office clerical. Thank you, Mrs. Freeman. Mr. Chris Sozick, 20 years at Liberty High School as a social studies teacher. Mr. Sozick. Mr. Kevin Gifford, 22 years at Liberty with a total of 27 years in the classroom, teaching in both Baltimore and Carroll County. Mr. Randy Conley, 25 years at Liberty as a special education teacher with a total of 29 plus years in the classroom, teaching in both Baltimore and Carroll County. Mr. Conley. And Mr. Tim Durkin, 34 years at Liberty as a physics teacher and a total of 45 years in the classroom, teaching in both Baltimore. Thank you all for your service. You will surely be missed. Next, I'd like to recognize the parents. Would the parents of our graduates please stand? Your support has been instrumental to the success of the students seated before you. You have assisted with homework, provided transportation to and from school and school events, attended parent conferences, athletic events, and finals performances, and provided the love and attention that are so crucial for children to grow and mature into young adults. Thank you for sharing your students with us. Today we celebrate their achievement with you. I'd now like to take the opportunity to highlight some of the many outstanding accomplishments of the class of 2024. 100 seniors reported being offered at least one scholarship. 68% of seniors who will be attending college were offered monetary scholarships. The total scholarship money awarded to this class is approximately $10.6 million. Approximately 69% of the class will be going to a four-year school, and 16% will be going to a two-year school, for a total of 85% attending college. (laughs) 123 seniors satisfied requirements of state-approved career completer programs at our school, at Century through JROTC, or at the Career Tech Center, while our CTE career completers, our junior ROTC students, and our career and tech students, please all stand. Would Jonas Flematu please stand? Jonas won a gold medal for finishing first in the State Skills USA competition in the field of engineering design and will move on to the National Skills USA competition. Congratulations, Jonas. We had four students that passed the Accounting 101 exam at Community College and will receive transcripted college credit. Also, three students passed the Business Administration 101 exam at the college and received transcriptive credit. 44 students, including our career and tech students, completed work-based internships through our Career Connections program. Three students participated in apprenticeships. Will our interns and apprenticeship students please stand? We had 35 students who received the President's Award of Excellence. These students have achieved a minimum unweighted 3.5 GPA and met one of the following scores on standardized assessments: an SAT math score of 650 or more, or an SAT reading and writing score of 650 or more, or an ACT composite score of 29. They are wearing pins to designate this honor. If you are a President's Award of Excellence awardee, please stand. Every year, the College Board recognizes students for outstanding performance on the PSAT. Less than 5% of students nationwide are selected as commended scholars. Liberty is proud to have two students who have been selected as commended scholars. Will Tim Wynn and Jonathan Lowry please stand and be recognized? The next group of students I'd like to recognize finished in the top 5% of the class of 2024 based on weighted GPA. They are wearing gold cords. In alphabetical order, please stand when your name is read. Aaron Ball, Alexys Esfandiari, Haley Biddy, Cameron Beard, Kevin Hemmerger, Jonathan Lowry, Katie Matter, Hannah Perkowski, Noah Petrosky, Maya Potter, and Veronica Sanchez, our top 5%. We'd like to honor our students who have received a final grade of A in every course for which they have received high school credit, including dual enrollment classes and classes they took while they were in middle school for high school credit. We are proud to announce that 25 students have achieved this honor. For the following students with a perfect final 4.0 unweighted GPA, please stand as your name is called. Aaron Ball, Grant Bernstein, Patricia Choi, Alexys Esfandiari, Haley Figge, Scott Biddy, Zach Grossmander, Bergen Hall, Gigi Hall, Kevin Hammaker, Jen Wynn, Layla Kaplan, Olivia Natcha Esty, Katie Matter, Anna Perkowski, Noah Petrosky, Maya Potter, Rita Reese, Sarah Rupert, Veronica Sanchez, Ashley Schwartz, Ayla Shea, Annika Ray, McKenna Wright, Abigail Young, and Kyle Young, straight A's for every course in high school. Liberty High School has chapters of the following honor societies: National Honor Society, National Art Honor Society, Tri-M Honor Society, and International Thespian Society. For the students who are members of those honor societies, please stand. There were 120 seniors in this class who took 242 AP exams in 22 different content areas this past spring. Of those students, 32 students successfully completed 7 or more AP courses during their high school career, earning the Principal's Award for Academic Excellence. For the following students, please stand when their name is read. Aaron Ball, Patricia Choi, and Cameron Fear. These three students successfully completed 12 AP courses while they were in high school. With Julia Bacon, Grace Provo, Flematu Fofana, Olivia Machaeski, Natalie Matthews, Noah Petrosky, Mariah Telford, and Sahi Sudhakar, please stand. These students are wearing teal and green cords for successfully completing College Board's AP Capstone program. AP Capstone is a two-year rigorous program created to equip students with independent research, collaborative teamwork, and communication skills that are increasingly valued in higher education and the workplace. Pending scores from this spring's testings, these scholars will also be eligible for additional recognition from College Board. Students who earn scores of 3 or higher in their 2 capstone courses, AP Seminar and AP Research, and on 4 additional AP exams, will receive the AP Capstone Diploma. It's a designation that is given nationwide. Congratulations. Senior class students completed one or more dual enrollment classes at Liberty High School or at Carroll Community, earning both high school and college credit. Will our dual enrollment students please stand and be recognized? Would our junior ROTC students and any graduate that plans to enter military service please stand and remain standing? So you keep standing. Now keep standing. Now I would ask any members of the audience who have served or are currently serving in the branch of the armed forces to please stand up and join me. Thank you for your service to our country. Students in the class of 2024 logged in more than 34,645 service hours for an average of 159 hours per seniors, yet only 75 hours were required. We have our top 10 exemplary service learning students that I will name in alphabetical order. Please stand when your name is called. Evan Barson, Sophia Cabrera, Alexys Esfandiari, Gigi Hall, Angie Jones, Mackenzie Lombard, Olivia Macieski, Maya Potter, Anna Sampere, and Emily Stampinato. Across town. Now I'm going to ask Anna to stand up again. Congratulations, Anna Sampere, on earning the most service hours in the class with 540 hours. I'd like to welcome our athletic director, Mr. Ed DeVincent, to the podium to share class accomplishments in athletics. Mr. DeVincent.
They were definitely not ready for me. I'm a little vertically challenged, sorry. Congratulations, class of 2024. And, you know, I wish you the best of luck in all your future endeavors. The academic achievements, crazy, unbelievable. When I graduated from Liberty 38 years ago, yes, 38 years ago, there was one AP course offered, and it was European history, and that was it. So the accomplishments that you've had academically is unbelievable. And you guys matched those accomplishments athletically. In the past 4 years, members of this class won many individual region and team championships. They won state championships in volleyball, cross country, tennis, and girls lacrosse. Let's hear more. This year, we won county championships in baseball, boys and girls tennis. We won regional championships. Tied for second most ever in Liberty's history with the amount that we won. boys soccer, girls soccer, boys cross country, girls cross country, boys indoor track, baseball, boys lacrosse, and tennis. Would the senior members of the boys cross country team please stand? Congratulations on winning the 1A state championship this year. Not only did they win, they obliterated their competition. Their score was 28. Second place was 134. So needless to say, these guys did an amazing job, and congratulations to you. Would the senior members of the boys indoor track and boys lacrosse team please stand? These two teams finished as state runner-up this year. Let's hear it for them. Can Ben Smith and Scott Figgy please stand? They were two-fourths of our 4x800-meter relay team that not only won the indoor state track and field championship, but also the outdoor state track and field championship. Let's hear it for you guys. Aiden Spies, please stand. Aiden was part of the boys' double team who won the state championship in tennis this year. In addition, we have many individual region and state champions or runners-up. Can you please stand to be acknowledged? I do have one more person. Everybody makes sports. We know sports is not just about the X's and O's and learning the game. It's also about the life skills and values that are going to help you become successful in whatever you do in life. Can Annika Ray please stand? Annika, the other week, was awarded the 13 Green National Leadership Award through the organization Lead 'Em Up. Not only a great athlete, but also a great leader. Congratulations, Annika. Class of 2024, congratulations again, and I wish you the best of luck in all your future endeavors. Thank you.
High School has continued its tradition of excellence with this graduating class. Will the members of the Lions Pride Marching Band please stand to be recognized? The Lions Pride Marching Band took first place with a score of 95.01 and awards for high music, high visual, high percussion, and high color guard, 2023 Tournament of Bands Region 5 for Greater Maryland, Virginia, and West Virginia championships in the Group 3 Open Class. They also won the 2023 Tournament of Bands Atlantic Coast Championship for the third time in school history with a score of 96.90, and awards for high music and high visual. Congratulations. The Wind Ensemble and Full Orchestra earned straight superior ratings at the 2024 Carol Music Assessment Festival. The Full Orchestra won first place and an excellent rating at the Williamsburg Music in the Parks Festival on April 6th this year, with a superior rating as well as best overall high school orchestra at the time of the competition. 23 students were invited to all county band, 9 students were invited to all county orchestra. Would Claire Chin please stand? Claire was invited to perform in the All-State Ensemble. Congratulations, Claire. For the Liberty Vocal Department, it was another year of achievements. The Liberty High School Combined Chorus received superior ratings at this year's County Adjudication Festival, making them eligible to participate in the Maryland State Choral Festival. Our Magical Chorus received excellent ratings. Members of our chorus competed in the Music in the Parks Choral Festival and also received superior ratings. Congratulations to our vocal music department. In our drama department, it was another year of accomplishments for the Liberty Lions Pride players. Will the senior members of the cast and crew of the fall play Sleepy Hollow and the spring musical Annie please stand to be recognized? With the senior members that performed their one-act play at the Maryland State Thespian Festival, please stand. This performance won Best Props. Isaac and Leon, you don't get away that easily. Isaac Quatira and Leon Obura, please stand. Isaac won Best Actor Award for his performance at festival, and Leon has won several theatrical scholarships. Congratulations. And our very own Miss Hannigan herself, Riley King, please stand. Riley represents our school and county throughout the year and at State Festival as a student thespian officer. Congratulations, Riley. And our Lillian, please stand, Patricia Choi. Yeah. Won Thespian of the Year Award for our Troop 984 for the Liberty International Thespian Society. Congratulations. The senior class has multiple students who excelled also in the visual arts. Among them are students whose work was juried in various locations across the state. Would the following students please stand to be recognized? Noah Petrosky, Emily Blevins, Riley King, Charlie Menendez, and Precious Akabode. Additionally, Noelle Fresher, Ava D'Angelo, Noah Petrosky again, Emily Blevins, Kira Morinelli, Riley King, Claire Chin, Pro Mullen and Sarah Ruprecht, please stand. Noelle Fresher's work was juried into the National Exhibition for the National Art Honor Society. Ava D'Angelo earned a Gold Key through the Scholastic Art and Writing Awards. Noah Petrosky and Emily Blevins had work featured in the BWI Youth Gallery. Kira Morinelli, Riley King, Ava D'Angelo, Emily Blevins, and Claire Chin had work published nationally by the National Art Education Association. Crow Mullen and Sarah Ruprecht had work in the Maryland Recycled Sculpture Contest. Noah Petrosky, Grace Krobo, Charlie Menendez, Paige Reisner, Julia Simmons, Julia Bacon, and Noelle Fresher are graduating senior members of the LHS mural team. All of the mural team, please stand to be recognized as well. Please be seated. There are a total of 37 graduating seniors as members of the National Art Honor Society. Congratulations to all.
you can see, our graduates are a very accomplished group, and I offer my congratulations to each of them for their many achievements. At the front of the platform is a memory bouquet of red roses. It stands here to honor the memory of classmates, graduates, and other members of our extended Liberty family who we have lost over the years. We especially remember classmate Ryan Krakunis, who we lost between his sophomore and junior year. Today, as we gather to celebrate your achievements, class of 2024, I'm filled with an overwhelming sense of pride and joy in your individual and collective accomplishments. Your journey to this moment has been nothing short of extraordinary, marked by moments of triumph, challenges, and above all, growth. Growth is a fundamental part of the human experience. It is the process of evolving, learning, and becoming the best version of ourselves. Throughout your time at Liberty, you have demonstrated an incredible capacity for growth, both academically and personally. Think back to your first day of high school. The nerves, the excitement, the uncertainty of what lay ahead. You were freshmen in every sense of the word, with a pandemic in progress to make the transition even more challenging. But since then, you have overcome countless obstacles, pushed the boundaries of your comfort zone, and embraced new opportunities for learning and self-discovery. However, growth is not just about academic achievements. It's also about your personal development and character building. Along the way, you've learned valuable lessons about resilience, perseverance, and the importance of stepping outside your comfort zone. So as you prepare to leave us, I encourage you to self-reflect on the growth you have experienced during your time in high school. Celebrate the challenges you have overcome, the skills you have acquired, and the friendships you have forged along the way. But remember, growth is a lifelong journey. It does not end with graduation. It is a continuous process of self-improvement and self-discovery. As you begin life after high school, I urge you to embrace the opportunities for growth that will come your way. Be open to new experiences, new perspectives, and new ways of thinking. Seek out challenges that push you outside of your comfort zone and sustain you as you continue to strive for excellence. Remember, growth often comes from embracing change and facing challenges head on. As you leave the familiar halls of Liberty and step out into the world, I have no doubt that you will continue to grow and thrive in all that you do. Your journey may have continued here at Liberty, but your potential for growth knows no bounds. Congratulations, graduates, on this momentous achievement. Your growth over the past 4 years has been truly inspiring, and I have no doubt that you will continue to achieve remarkable things in the years ahead. So congratulations, class of 2024. The tradition has been established that the student speaker for graduation is chosen from those students who auditioned for this honor. And I'm proud to invite Flematu Fofana to the podium at this time.
Proud parents. Good afternoon and welcome. My name is Flematu Fofana. I'm a senior here at Liberty High School, and it is an honor to welcome you all and stand before you as we recognize the achievements of the remarkable class of 2024. Graduates, throughout these past few weeks, you've probably been told more than once to focus on the present. A very true and important statement, but I'd like to take a little bit of time to talk about something that often goes unnoticed, love. Love costs all we are and all we'll ever be. Yet, it is only love that sets us free. Now, love comes in many forms. Romantic love, platonic love, familial love, self-love. Love is everywhere, and it is this feeling we call love that has gotten us to walk this stage in cap and gown. The accumulation of all the love you received in your lifetime is the reason that you are here today, getting ready to enter the next stage of your life. They say it takes a village. It takes a village to raise a child, put them through schooling, and allow them to earn a diploma. And I think sometimes it's often easy for us to devalue this idea of love because we've become blind. I mean, when something is around you all the time, you take it for granted. But I'd like to take a step back so we can see just how powerful this thing we call love is. I need a little bit of audience participation at this time, so members of the audience, please stand or raise your hand and remain standing if the following scenarios apply to you. Have you ever taken time out of your day to attend a game, a showcase, or performance of a graduate here? Have you ever spent your hard-earned money on graduation attire, dresses, sports equipment, spirit wear, or any other school materials for a graduate? And please remain standing as well. Have you ever made both big and small sacrifices for the sake of a graduate here? And then finally, are you here to see a graduate walk the stage today? Graduates, if you could just turn around and see, this right here is love. The love these audience members possess for you today. Thank you. You all can keep going. Now, if love is the seed, then gratitude is the stem that shoots from it. This is why, when you leave this room, you go back to your village and you thank them. You thank them for the time and the money they invested, the love they gave and will continue to give. Because from gratitude comes love, a never-ending cycle in which generations can be supported. You are the next stepping stone of your lineage. You are your ancestors' wildest dreams. It is not just the people in this audience that are here supporting you. For those before us, completing a high school education or obtaining a diploma was not the norm. With each step you now take as a graduate, you hold the support of your ancestors who were never given a chance to obtain a diploma. Whether present today or not, we all have a village of people behind us whose love and support is what got us to this point. But that village cannot move mountains without the least bit of motivation from the individual. Whether you think so or not, there was something in you that said, in 4 years, this is where you want to be. And it might not seem like it was that hard or like it was that big of a deal to get here, but obtaining a high school diploma is not the norm, so take pride in yourself. You loved yourself enough to work hard, earn a diploma, and for that, many doors will open for you. The possibilities are merely confined to your imagination. As we shift from the realm of imagination, where we dream of possibilities and envision futures yet to come, we must also pause to acknowledge the profound reality of cherished souls that have been lost. Ryan Cortunas was a kind and genuine soul. His friends stating he didn't have a single bad bone in his body, with a smile that could light up a room, a smile that was taken too soon from this world. It would not be right to stand here before you without acknowledging this great loss for his family and our class. As we move forward in life, we must remember life will always be unpredictable, put us through our happiest and worst times, but we have people in our corner, and because of love, they will always be on our side. Love is what keeps us tethered to what we hold dearest. It provides us with motivation to reach our highest selves. It gives us community when we're in times of need. And when you give love, receive it back. Because love is not transactional. It grows and grows and grows. So, wear your cap and gown with pride. Turn your tassel as you turn to a life that those before you could have never imagined. And choose love. Because when you're at your lowest, it is love that will save you and love that will heal us all. Thank you.
Thank you, Flematu.
This time, we would like the Liberty High School Chorus to please come forward. The Liberty High School Chorus, under the direction of Ms. Sarah Larson, would now sing Stand By Me. Thank you.
Hey, Leon.
This year's class has asked Mr. Jesse Harrington to speak this afternoon. It is my pleasure to invite him to the podium.
The amazing faculty and staff of Liberty High School, and the parents and family who have come to witness this day. The class of 2024, this is your time. When I was told that the students had nominated me to be the commencement speaker, all I could think of is, nah, it's right, that ain't me. But as the day continued, everywhere I walked, students came up to me saying, I voted for you. I want you to be our speaker. So I guess I'm who you got, so let me begin. 4 scores and 7 years ago.
Long speech.
Okay, well, let me try again. Ask not what your country can do. Oh, practice alone?
Yeah, shoot.
Okay, I got it. Liberty High School, class of 2022, will always have a special place in my heart. This was the first group of students that welcomed me into their environment. I can remember in my first year, Mr. Goncz said, I can tell you from all these kids right now. Chemistry is the study of matter, but I prefer to look at it as the study of change. Okay, so I'm not really a science guy. I know enough to play Jeopardy, but that's my fault. But one animal that has always intrigued me is the butterfly. How many of you like butterflies? Come on, y'all gotta like the butterflies. All right. Some people believe that the butterfly is the most beautiful animal in the world. Your life is just like that butterfly. You must remember that the butterfly didn't begin as this beautiful creature that you see. To become this beautiful creature that we all love, it goes through a metamorphosis, a chemical change. Y'all know what I mean. It begins as an egg, then it spends a great deal of its lifetime as a caterpillar. This is a time that it appears as a hairy little worm. Stick with me for a minute, you'll catch on with it. The past 12 years have been your caterpillar stage, and you made it. When I reflect on your high school experience, you all experienced things that no other high school in history would ever experience. You entered Liberty High School during a pandemic, and your classroom became your bedroom. Your sophomore year, you returned to school, and you had to figure out, how do I adjust to being back in school? Your junior year, technology became your friend, and ChatGPT became your best friend. This year, your final year, you made it. You ugly little caterpillars, it's time to break out that cocoon. These past 12 years, you have demonstrated resilience and resourcefulness, commitment, determination, and our completion. No one saw the study sessions after school with Mr. Parker. No one was there when you called, when you asked us how we could pause you to help you finish that English paper. No one was there when you practiced band instruments late into the night with Ms. Jason, or stayed late in the wee hours with Ms. Dixon rehearsing for Emmy. Y'all know I'm still scattered by her. That takes resilience and determination. Never forget the process that got you here. I can remember my first week, a particular young girl came up to me and said, "I'm so happy you're here. We need you. Are you going to be our BSU advisor?" I just said, "Of course. Do you want to do my job to you?" That was my first personal recruit. Our team over the next few years will consist of 8 more seniors and going to lose now only one game in the conference over 3 years. That takes a commitment. Class of 2024, I'll miss our morning talks with the media center and being asked, "Is that your daughter?" And I'll miss our lunch conversations and being asked by kids in my class, "Is that your daughter?" Or I miss my guys hanging out there after school talking about nothing and everything. Leon being asked, "Are they real sons?" 246, dude. Oh gosh. I'll miss the jokes and laughter I share with each one of you as I walk down the hall or came into one of your classes. I'll miss saying my favorite words to some of you, "Get out my classroom and go to class." But as you go off into the world, take your talents to places as Carroll Community College, UMBC, Maryland, Rutgers, Oklahoma, UCLA, Florida, Yale. Continue to break forth. Fly like those butterflies. Let the world see the beauty of your talents. Grow into the person in which your parents invested. Rely on what has been instilled in you, and success will come. Will the journey be easy? No. But will it be worth it? No doubt. A few weeks ago, I walked down the hall after school. I passed one of your classmates, and I said, "Hello, such and such." The student looked back at me in surprise and said, "You know my name. People often forget who I am." My response to that student was the same as I would say to any of you. You matter. You are impactful, and the world will never forget who you are. If I can leave you with one thing, just one thing, let me leave you with this. I have a dream. Oh, no, crap. That's the wrong one. No, but seriously, let me quote one of my favorite lyricists from my hometown, Detroit, Rose 59. He says, "Remember, while you're praising a butterfly, never, ever disrespect the caterpillar. Always remember the process that got you to where you are. And you must always remember that the process is greater than the outcome. Class of 2024, the world is yours. Now go out and take it."
Thank you, Mr. Harrington. The main purpose of us being here together this afternoon is to recognize the achievement of everyone who has met graduation requirements. The award associated with this achievement is a high school diploma. And to honor this achievement, I'd like to introduce Superintendent Dr. Cynthia McCabe.
Will the graduates please stand? It is with great pleasure and pride that I officially present the graduating class of 2024 of Liberty High School for the awarding of diplomas. The members of the Board of Education of Carroll County, the principal of Liberty High School, Mr. Goncz, and I certify that these graduates have successfully completed all of the requirements for a Maryland High School diploma or certificate. Congratulations to each of you. Diplomas to our students seated on the stage. Class President McKenna Elizabeth Wright. Valedictorian Alexys Sophia Esfandiari. Salutatorian Cameron Allen Peer. Our student speaker, Flematu Fatima Fofana. Student member on the Board of Education, Cynthia Sudhakar.
Shabam Agarwal. Kamikaya Precious Akindole. Michael Alexander. Parker William Allen. Mason Blake Ambrose. Ivy Jean Anderson. Anna Vivian Anderson. Nikhil Venkatasai Onhavarapu. Jackson Boyd Andrews. Savannah Lynn Lyons Atwell. Kaylin Elena Hall. Darrell Awagani. Julia K. Bacon. Austin Christopher Baker. Aaron James Ball. Zacharias Baptiste.
Tristan Evan Samir Farsoon. By Bill. Jason William Bennett. Kevin Andrew Fernandezowski. Grant Ryan Bernstein. Veronica Valentina Bahama. Caitlin Alice Elizabeth Bayless. James Tower Birch. John Charles Blackford. Jonas Dean Latell. Emily Catherine Levins. Sydney Ann Bolger. Laura Paige Brockley.
Luke Timothy Burke. Sophia Carolina Cabrera. Jason Michael Campbell. Gabriella Marie Carbone. Jana Amelia Santofonti. Patricia Beauty Choi. Ash Kaufman. Evelyn Ann Connor. Julia Cook. Elizabeth Graham. Yeah! Savannah Sky Craven. Grace Delaney Rose. Jasper Rose Sugar.
Casey Elizabeth Seifert. Jordan Aaron Dawson. Jessica Alana De La Cruz. Vincent Anthony Dercola. James Michael DeVan. Ava Lee D'Angelo. Rocco Charles Deeks. Camille Judy Mariga Dobbs. Danica Jalen Ennett Eve. Tatiana Lee Eckenrod. Austin Jesse Isel Stager. Aiden Michael Ellis. Natalie Jordan Allen.
Joseph Brian Enum. Sarah Desmond. Ellen May Evans. Haley Michelle Figgins. Scott Adam Figgins. Aaron Arorgan Phelps. Brady Robert Fitzpatrick. Nicholas Harlan Forster. Anna Deborah Purdue. Jeremy Joe Gaston. Kate Olivia Graham. Dominic Alistair Harper. Zachary Fred Grosslinger. Patrick Smith Lindsay. Diana Megan Goody. Kendall Ashley Gunsberg. Justin Patrick Bezos. Isaac Rufar Wachur. Ryan Alexander Hagen. Bergen Alexander Hall. Gigi Riley Hall. Logan James Hall. Kevin A. Cash Hamiser. Benjamin Patrick Hamm. Noah Wilson Harmon. Christian Harrell. Connor Reed Hatfield. Justin Alex Huber.
Emma Faith Henderson. Carter Dell Henderson. Madison Lynn Holden. Layla Marie Hoffman. Maxwell Houston Holbein. Sean James Wharton.
Yes, Sean!
Adam Thomas Happ. Griffin Thomas Hughes. Tim Nguyen Nguyen. Julia Elizabeth Logan Mantina. Sebastian Isaza. Noella Michelle Isagiri. Zachary Marcus Jackson. Seth Andrew Jacobs. Jocelyn Ray Jamich. Cole Thomas Dermigan. Leandro Lee Jeter. Angela Gardner Jones. Layla K. Kaplan. Michaela Eileen Kaiser. Maria Perl. Riley Christina King. Tyler Joseph Kirchner. Rose Junois Larner. Mia Kim Leonhardt. Lauren Hope Locke. Mackenzie Lynn Lombard. Trent Carl Long. Olivia Ann Machiavelli. Grace Noel Martin. Andrew Alexander Meany. Miranda Ann Maranaccio. Ethan Shane Marshall. Nico John Marcicano. Michael Dominic Martin. Catherine Abigail Mattern. Natalie E. Matthews.
Brianna Marie Mendiola Marshall. Charlie Menendez. Brianna Cassidy Minor. Tolu Cecilia Molapu. Kira Ruby Morinelli. Crow Lee Mullen.
Alex Joseph Pearl. Quinn Carlos Pendleton. Hannah Marguerite Perkowski. Sydney Elizabeth Perry. Noah Daniel Petrosky. Patrick Grace Peak. Elizabeth Grace Playstead. Mason Patrick Plummer. Maya Wake Potter. Kinsey Isabella Lillian Hughes. Historian Nathan Ronchikar. Nicholas Matthew Rattel. Nicholas Kevin Reed. Rita Cecilia Reese. Paige Marie Reeson. Victoria Ripple. Liam McCoy Rogers. Joseph Richard Robach. Pitt Lee Robach.
Dylan James Rubin. Alyssa Rose Ruff. Gracelyn Nicole Rumpel. Sarah Ann Ruprecht. Haley Nicole Sadler. Veronica Lucy Sanchez. Samantha Christine Song. Anderson Douglas Schreiner. Ashley Elizabeth Schwartz. Meghan Elizabeth C. Jack William Sellers. Yeah! Austin Drake Shade. Isla Renee Shade. Adam David Fleischer. Ben William Smith. Lee Smith. Anna Lauren Zomperek. Nicole Fonquier Thong. Emily Joy Spampanato.
Hayden Hollis Spees. Morgan Elizabeth Stein. Trey Matthew Swanson. Julia Ann Simmons. Mariah Rebecca Talford. Mariana Rowan Taylor. Dwinick Finwin. William Alexander Thompson. Noelle Annalyn Thresher. Marley Ashlyn Tingler. Catherine Ann Tokar. Brooklyn Catherine Betty Tyler. Raleigh Eleanor Upton. Kira Rain Vassilaris. Lucas Michael Waltow. Kylie Michelle Welch. Grant Matthew White. Annika Lee Jane Gray. Abigail Mackenzie Young. Kyle LeBrand Young. Kayla Jean Marie Zapp. Victoria Ann Zuba.
Graduates, please stand. Ladies and gentlemen, I now present to you the graduating 43rd graduating class of Liberty High School. Please lead the class in the changing of the tassels.
The changing of the tassels signifies moving from student to graduate. At this time, graduates, please join me in moving your tassels from right to left.
We ask the audience to please wait for the students to recess before leaving and meet your graduates outside of the venue after they receive their packets.